Guys, today is Sunday, 16th. Gonna get this feller out here, start getting all set up for mowing, chopping my leaves up and stuff, get some crud and stuff here to get out of the way. Organize some stuff here, and I'm gonna prop our door open here because for some odd reason our door don't like to stay open on this end as that one there does. I've seemed to misplace my sunglasses. I looked everywhere. I see we got some reworking to do on this basket here, but there's what I'm looking for. I'll get that later. It's pinched in there right now, but that's an old microwave I've been saving for better purposes. I get a hitch pin there, dug out. Toolbox I might be putting in the might be putting in my pickup truck, probably along with that smaller one there, or vice versa. But I'm gonna have to back the four-wheeler out so I can hook onto this with my tractor. If it'll even start. It's been a week since I've run this thing, so I don't know. Wow-wee, that thing start. Oh, but we're plumb out of gas. Look at that. Out of gas. Uh-oh. That's all right. I'll hardly be riding the thing anymore. I'm still going to keep it, though, but just not riding around in the colder months and that. Four-wheeler out of here. Just now we got to move some stuff around and get the... I know what to do with these. Instead of letting them here get exposed to the weather. Lay them up there for now with my clothes and that, and... Oh crap, that's a shirt I gotta get back to a friend. Darn it. Couple odds and ends. That's a straight pipe there for the 720. Dad won't let me put it on it. But I know a guy that's got a tractor with a straight pipe on it. One lonely farmer. It's got a 720 diesel with a straight pipe on it. Okay. Get all this junk here out of the way. Yeah, I gotta get a lock for this thing. Don't even want a lock anymore. Just set that right there for now. And then I'd like to see too if maybe that John Deere Gator will fit in here. I don't know if it will or not. I'm kind of curious to see if it will. Oh. Cow. Wow. This is the first time I've opened this box, and look at the present I found inside here. Holy cow, am I ever thankful. Wow. Thank you. I know who exactly gave them to me. It was a family member. Wow, thank you, sir. He does not have a YouTube channel, but Thank you, buddy. I like the toolbox, but not too entirely crazy about the camo color. That is that. Yeah, next little clip, this will be on the tractor. That don't look right. That shouldn't be doing that. So we get issues. Looks funny. Plus I got a hole punched in here. I could get that pin there out. I got a pair of vice grips somewhere. Not vice grips, these guys here. Methinks if I just grip on that. Okay, so we got the extension tube, or not the tube, the I guess the tube, anywho. Let's see here, this part goes back here. It goes like that. We get this boot up here that it's a real pain in the bugger to put on. I gotta have two hands to do this, so you won't be seeing me try and video and put this thing on, but we'll definitely show you what it all looks like. There's two bolts here. There's four holes, but it's just fine with two bolts. It's the way it's always worked. So get them out, get that, throw it on, then we'll move to the next step. I got the discharge thing all bolted down. I took a 9/16 wrench and held under the bottom of that and tightened these down with a socket till they're good and tight. But now this thing here is giving me fits. It's hitting right here, these little tabs. There's one on the bottom side as well. I've been fighting with it for 15 minutes. I can't get it to go up and over, so I think maybe if I spin it to this, where this rubber here comes up, just you can see it come up a little bit right there. I think maybe that'll help me get it on, but I'm going to keep fighting with this, see if I can't get him up to here at least. I think I got him right where I want him. You can see there's no more tabs showing. I think what this is for up here is for a bigger hose is what this tab is. But then you gotta run this guy, his span clamp, up here. And I think, if I remember right, it went right here. I got my screwdriver here. We'll just... not try and impale myself. That would be a great thing. Well, daggone it. Well, you can kind of see it getting tight to where I can hardly move it. Oh, I'm sitting on the floor, so. Hmm. I think that ought to be tight enough. We'll come back here and try and put the back on. This hole there looks a lot smaller than what we got up here. Had to swing this out of the way. We gotta do the same thing here. We gotta loosen this guy up here quite a bit. A lot better than seeing it lay here on the floor all in pieces. We got to put that back in our toolbox. I gotta get that cleaned out someday too. Slow moving vehicle sign. I've got our tarp strap, or our bungee strap here. Tarp strap, bungee strap, whatever you guys want to call these things. These are bungee straps, because they stretch in the middle and allow you to do all kind of fancy fun stuff with them. And that just hangs up like, yeah, I think it's discolored stuff. There's some dragging on the gravel and that all the time and stuff, and pull my block of wood out here because we don't need it no more. I had that under there just to try and keep the hold the mower up while I was working under it so it didn't come down and fall on me. That one's got air in a tire yet. And this one's got air in a tire yet. They're a little bit squishy, but that's a kind of way I like them, is a little bit squishy. This is a, what is this thing? Briggs & Stratton, the same thing, same kind of motor that's in that, in my Gator over there. But this is a 900cc, 9 horsepower. Yeah, there he says 9 horsepower. Choke is off. Or no, choke is on? What would the choke be on? Turn our gas on. Pull the choke. This is one of them Everstart deals. First start machine. So here we go. Oops, you know what? I forgot to check my oil. It says oil fill there. There's where you check a oil. Ooh. Oof. I can't get that guy off. I don't even know why I tried to crank that thing without even checking the engine oil. Because that's one good way of blowing them things up is, you know, not checking the engine oil on that. You blow them up, why, they might as well be done. There's no fixing them, no stuff like that. I hope it's got gas in it as well. Oop, went the wrong way. Righty tighty, lefty loosey. You gotta remember that. There it comes. Yep. It's got a wool in it. I think you guys can see that. It's got a wool, so that's good. Let me get a rag out of here and wipe my finger off before I try and continue starting that thing. The other blower I had, it was a homemade deal, and it didn't quite work the way I wanted it to. It was always plugging up at the impeller. This has got a different blower on it than what mine had. The other one was a 5 horsepower job where
Ooh, good grief. Huh. They're gone. Huh. I can't get that off. I thinks we out of gas.
Starting this silly thing wrong.
You think maybe that's gas? Choke?
It runs!
Me thought it ran. That's weird. I can't get things started again. Weird. I don't know. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Please comment, rate, subscribe. Thanks for watching. There once, maybe that'll get it to pop. Come on. Our plug was fouled. That's what the problem was. Our plug was no good. Well, so we're gonna shove it in now and see what it'll do, if it'll run on its own or not. What I done took a spark plug, as you've seen. It's got gasoline in it. You can see there, it's got gas. But I'm baffled as to why it ain't wanting to run. It'll run with ether, you know, starting fluid, but that's it. I bet you it's a dang daggone carburetor right there. I don't know, guys. I don't know what to do. You guys tell me what to do. Oh. I don't remember how to work on these carburetors, or adjust them, or do anything since I went to my vocational school. Float could be sticking, I don't know. Comment, rate, subscribe, thanks for watching. We'll eventually get her figured out, I hope.